are live on Facebook.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا ولما رأى المؤمنون الأحزاب قالوا هذا ما وعدنا الله ورسوله قالوا هذا ما وعدنا الله ورسوله وصدق الله ورسوله وما زادهم إلا إيمانا وتسليما من المؤمنين رجال صدقوا ما عاهدوا الله عليه فمنهم من قضى نحبه ومنهم من ينتظر وما بدلوا تبديلا ليجزي الله الصادقين بصدقهم ويعذب المنافقين إن شاء أو يتوب عليهم ليجزي الله الصادقين بصدقهم ويعذب المنافقين إن شاء أو يتوب عليهم إن الله كان غفورا رحيما صدق الله العظيم.
إن شاء الله تبارك الله. جزاكم الله خيرا شيخنا بارك الله فيكم. Really, mashallah, we enjoy your recitation. And I believe that my brothers and sisters who are listening and watching right now, they have the same feeling. You are refreshing our hearts before the iftar. Barakallahu fikum, Shaykhana. And we have Imam Jalal. Assalamu alaikum, Imam Jalal.
Alaikum salam wa rahmatullah, asyadna, ahlan wa sahlan, sahib al-fadila, mashallah. Jazakallah khairan. Shaykhna, Shaykh Hisham, mashallah, sawt ra'a wa haga gameela, mashallah. Rabbina yahmi ya rabbi bhai jahallah.
Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. That's by the blessings of Allah. I just told him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent you at the last days or the last 10 nights of Ramadan so you can refresh our hearts a little bit. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from him, Allahumma ameen ya rabbil alameen. And alhamdulillah, I can see the brothers and sisters started to join our session, alhamdulillah. And today's khatira and today's lecture before the iftar, and I will give back inshallah to Imam Hisham one more time inshallah for the dua. But before that, we have our imams, Imam Muhammad Yahya, and we have Imam Jalal. And we wanted to talk today about one of the names, one of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I believe it is the center of attention these days. And when it comes to the last 10 nights or the last 7 nights in Ramadan, what remains, and seeking the night of Laylatul Qadri, the most of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we focus on, that we are concentrating on, is the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Afu. And that is why the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, narrated by Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anha, and it is muttafaqun alayhi, that means it is agreed upon. And this hadith, as we know, as we hear every year, alhamdulillah, and I believe you guys, mashallah, you almost memorized the hadith of Sayyida Aisha related to the night of the night of decree, the night of power, related to Laylatul Qadr, when she said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Messenger of Allah, what do you think if I observed Laylatul Qadr, if I notice that this is Laylatul Qadr, what is the supplication, what is the dua that I wanted to say during this night? He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, very simple dua, but at the same time, it is very comprehensive dua. And the dua that, as you know, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قولي, say during this night, اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عني. Oh Allah, you are the most forgiving and you love to forgive. Oh Allah, forgive my sins. So that's the dua. It is so simple and it's so easy to memorize, inshallah. But at the same time, it is a very deep meaning. It is related to one of the names of Allah, Al-Afu. Al-Afu means the most forgiving. And just wanted to make it easy, as simple and as much as I can, to have that comparison between two of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The name of Allah, Al-Ghafur, the one who forgives the most, and the name of Allah, Al-Afu. Why exactly the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used the name of Allah, Al-Afu, and he did not use the name of Allah, Al-Ghafur? Actually, because Al-Afu is more comprehensive, is more wider than Al-Ghafur. And I remember last year when I told my brothers and sisters in the masjid, Al-Ghafur means that the one who forgives. But Al-Afu, it has two F. And not only he forgives, but he, subhanahu wa ta'ala, he forgets. That means it will be wiped out. So it means that your sins will not be mentioned on the day of judgment. No one can see your sins. Not only you will delete your past, not only you will delete your sins, but at the same time, it will not be in the record. It will not be in your book of bad deeds. That means it will be wiped out completely. And that is by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you wanted to ask Allah this night, not only to forgive your sins, if you said, Allahumma innaka ghafoor, that means that Allah will forgive the sins, but it will remain, it will stay there in your record. Maybe your relatives, your family members, they will know about your sins. But when you ask about, oh Allah, you are the Afu, and if Allah accepted that dua, you will never see all the bad deeds in your record. And one of the things that I wanted to highlight tonight, when it comes to our daily, you know, interaction, when you ask somebody a favor, like, for example, when you have a brother, when you have a your boss, your manager, your neighbor, when you ask him for a favor for once, twice, third time, or thrice, when you ask him multiple times, he gets bored. And maybe you feel shy to ask somebody many times to make a favor for you. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is different. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is completely different. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do not feel shy to ask him many times. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always, Allah gets angry at actually if you did not ask him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gets angry. It means like you are not in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That you are telling Allah, oh Allah, I don't need you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, Ya ayyuha an-nas, antumul fuqara'u ila Allah. You are in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are in absolute need for him. And Allah is the most rich, that Allah is the most, you know, and he has the absolute control subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah needs you to ask him. Do not feel shy to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we know, Allah is the king of the kings. He is Malikul Muluk. And sometimes, or in our dunya, in our life, when you get closer to one of the, you know, those people who have a high status in dunya, high position in dunya, when you are getting closer to them, sometimes they are, you know, get bored. And sometimes you feel embarrassed to ask them many times. That's why they said, Kullu abwab al muluk maktubun alayha mamnu'u al-iqtirab illa bab al-malik famaktubun alayhi wasjud waqtarib. All the gates of the kings in our dunya, you will find that sign. Do not get closer, or you will be caught on camera, you know, except the gate of Allah, the king of the kings. He is telling you in the Quran, come on, prostrate to me, make sujood to Allah and get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Especially when you have no mediator between you and Allah. You know, we have the kings or the presidents, they have always what we call it in the Arabic term, we call hujjab or hajib. Someone is blocking you from entering to the president or the king. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he did not make any mediator between you and him. Even that mediator wasn't Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why Allah said, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي. When my servant, when my slaves asks you about me, he said, فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. He did not use the same pattern, the same example in the Quran. Oh Muhammad, قُلْ. Oh Muhammad, say to them. This is one of the exceptions in the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. Directly, I'm very closer to them. I'm very near to them. And let them make the dua. And no mediator. We do not have in Islam like other faith, like other religion, that you have a mediator between you and God. So you have to confess to the rabbi or the priest or, you know, no, even the imams, they are giving you the knowledge how to get closer to Allah, but they are not mediator between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So do not feel shy during these nights to ask Allah for forgiveness and call him by his name. Allah, you are the Afu. I ask you to forgive me. I ask you to be Afu to me, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let me go back very quickly to Imam Jalal, and I'm sure that he will tell us more about the name of Allah, Al-Afu, and what's the difference between Al-Afu and Al-Ghafur, inshallah. Yes, Imam Jalal.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. May Allah bless you, Imam Ahmed, Ameen, Rabbil Alameen, for this beautiful and wonderful gathering. and may Allah gather us together inshallah in paradise. Ameen ya rabbil alameen. Allah Azza wa Jal said at the last verse of the Surah Al-Baqarah, the longest surah in the Quran, wonderful, beautiful surah in the Quran. Allah Azza wa Jal said, wa'fu anna waghfir lana. Wallahi, can you imagine Imam Ahmad? Wallahi, we are so poor. Wallahi, we are so poor. We cannot even make dua to Allah. So Allah teaches us how to make dua to Him. Allahu Akbar, ya akhi. Wallahi, merciful, the most merciful. Subhanallah al-Azim. What to expect? So alhamdulillah, one of the things that we praise Allah, glory be to Him, we praise Allah because He is Allah. No one else, wallahi, it's gonna be, if somebody else, wallahi, it's gonna be, Allah, subhanallah al-Azim, miserable for us and calamity. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, wa'fu anna, and you burden us. Waghfir lana, and you forgive us. Warhamna, subhanallah al-Azim, and have mercy upon us. Allahu Akbar, anta maulana. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla said also, ثُمَّ عَفَوْنَا عَنْكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala burden them after that, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ, in order, maybe you be among the grateful to Allah and thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah Azza wa Jalla said also about الشيطان يعدكم الفقر. The Satan, the devil, the evil, Iblis, he threatened us with poverty and to be poor and to lose everything. وَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ, and he ordered us with the badness and to do the evil stuff and evil things. وَاللَّهُ يَعِدُكُمْ مَغْفِرَةً مِّنْهُ وَفَضْلًا, and Allah Azza wa Jal, I do apologize because my voice today is have a little issue, but alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, jazakum Allah khair. So, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but Allah Azza wa Jal, glory be to Him, He promised us with the forgiveness, subhanallah al-azim, from Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah said, إِلَّا أَنَّ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ, those people who are the believers, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, they are afraid and fear from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةً, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them the forgiveness. So the most, or the difference between the al-afu is the one who burden us, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. But al-ghafur is the one who, like you said, Imam Ahmed, may Allah bless you, is the one who forgive all, you know, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, doesn't even mention it. May Allah bless you, and may Allah make have a burden upon all of us and all Muslim, amma ameen ya rabbil alameen, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all our sins. Ameen ya rabbil alameen. Jazakumullah khairan habib.
Barakallahu feekum for coming. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, and may Allah give you shifa inshallah. For I know it's hard for these days, especially the imams after Ramadan, they need to have remedy and medicine for their throats. May Allah accept from all of us. Allahumma ameen ya rabbil alameen. So we mentioned that do not feel shy to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He is al-afu. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes you to ask Him many times. I will get back to Imam Yahya, inshallah. I will get to Imam Yahya so we can know more about how to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imam, we wanted to encourage everyone these days. Do not feel shy, no matter what you have, no matter what you made, no matter how much things that you made. So, and these are the days of forgiveness. These are the days that you can ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as the poet said, لَا تَسْأَلَنَّ بُنَيَّ آدَمَ حَاجَةً وَسَلِ الَّذِي أَبْوَابُهُ لَا تُحْجَبُ اللَّهُ يَغْضَبُ إِن تَرَكْتَ سُؤَالَهُ وَبُنَيُّ آدَمَ حِينَ يُسْأَلُ يَغْضَبُ. So do not ask the child of Adam, but ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah does not get angry when you ask Him too much. So what do you think about this, Imam?
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. These are a very, very blessed moments in the month of Ramadan, in the last 10 nights of Ramadan, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow His mercy upon us. And when we receive all these blessings, when we gather, and you know, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam promised those who gather to recite the Quran in the house of Allah, it's not just restricted to the masjid. The fact is that, you know, whenever we have any kind of something that prevent us from gathering at the masjid, or we try to gather on online just like this, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam promised that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention us in his group in the heavens, and the angel will be surrounding us, and our, you know, our sins will be forgiven, inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the best dua, as our mashayikh mentioned, to say during the last nights of Ramadan, and look how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is very accurate and is very profound giving us this dua. Because the fact, as we mentioned before, you don't have to make a lot of rhythm when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It means that you don't have to say Allahumma salli fawqa al-ard wa tahta al-ard wa yawm al-ard. You don't have to do all of these things. Is it enough for you just to follow the track of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Whatever you have in the narrations of al-Ma'thur about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam dua, it is very comprehensive. It is even more than enough for you to ask Allah for. And by the way, you could find the best dua ever, inshallah, at the end of each mushaf, you know, the right dua, Khatm al-Quran, there are a lot of adaya narrated by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So still we are talking about this dua, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbu al-afwa fa'afu anna. And they mentioned, our mashayikh, that afu is higher than forgiveness. It means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins in both of them, but in afu, your sin will be like wiped out from your sheet, wiped out from your book, that you're not going to see it on the day of judgment. And this is the same when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the spending money for his sake in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ مَاذَا يُنْفِقُونَ قُلِ الْعَفُ. الْعَفُ هُنَا يعني الزيادة. الزيادة ما زاد على المال. So whatever you have, whenever you have afu, it means like something extra. Extra. What is extra? What is after forgiveness? It means that Allah will wipe out your sins from your sheet. So this is a glad tidings from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So if you just keep saying Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbu al-afwa fa'fu 'anna all the time, it is sufficient for you, inshallah. Another thing about afu is that this action, you know, we have to experience and to practice this action all around the place and in between ourselves. Like, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of course, told us that there are three things that they will not be on the scale. They will not be counted on the scale, like one hasana will be multiplied by 10 or even 700. No, the ajr and the reward for afu is just for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody could know how much rewards you get when you pardon other people. So the point here, if we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pardon us and to forgive our sins, we have also to take an initiative step to pardon each other. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ عَفَى وَأَصْلَحَ فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. There are just three actions, al-afu, was-sabr, was-siyam. And alhamdulillah, we experience siyam and sabr every single day. If you want to make the most of this Ramadan, and if you want to make the most of your life, try to add this to your credit. Alhamdulillah, we make siyam. Alhamdulillah, we experience sabr all the day long. So if we pardon each other, so we combine all of them, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. And in all cases, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised that he will give us even beyond what we could count or we could imagine. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most generous, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Just I'm going to close with this point, which is we don't have a specific narration tells that Laylatul Qadr is in the 27th. It might be the last night, it might be the, you know, the ninth of 25th, it might be 27th, it might be 29th, it might be any night. So the point is that we should have to exert our effort all the time. Do you know when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that there is a certain hour in the day of Jumu'ah that Allah will respond and will answer our dua? When is this hour? Nobody could tell you that it's right before Salat al-Jumu'ah or after Salat al-Fajr or right before Salat al-Maghrib. Nobody knows why. What is the wisdom behind it? In order to encourage us, to let us make dua and to invest every single moment in the day of Jumu'ah. Same thing here, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hid Laylatul Qadr, in the last 10 nights of Ramadan, it means that we have to exert our effort as much as we can during the rest of the nights. And then, subhanAllah, it's just a little and a few nights left in the month of Ramadan. So please exert your effort, get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should act every night as if it is the night of Qadr. We should respond and we should act according to this concept. Every single night from now on, we are going, inshallah, to act like we are 100% sure that this is Laylatul Qadr. If we still have like six nights in the month of Ramadan, we have to exert effort at the same level. Try to do your best. Even if your sleep will be affected a little bit, you know, subhanAllah, it's just 1 week, and we'll get back to our daily routine as we do throughout the year. So the month of Ramadan is a big opportunity, the big chance for each and everybody to invest and to make the most of it. Don't ever miss these blessings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala offers His mercy. And our role is to take an najab step, as we said, and to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all of these blessings in the month of Ramadan. And again, try to keep saying this dua, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anna. May Allah pardon us all. Jazakumullahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum.
Barakallahu feekum. Jazakumullahu khairan. And really, it's something good to take the advantage of having, you know, three imams in one session, Imam Hisham, Imam Jalal, and Imam Muhammad. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. And I will get back to Imam Hisham, inshallah, for the dua. And just wanted to welcome all the brothers and sisters. May Allah bless you. Allahumma ameen. And I think, alhamdulillah, you need to have this step forward, inshallah, by planning for the night of 27th of Ramadan, as the masajid, inshallah, will be opened during the night for partial i'tikaf. And you can see lots of programs, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. So may Allah accept from all of us, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Let's take the most and the advantage of the last, what remains in the nights of Ramadan. I just wanted to let you or alert you and be aware of some of the narrations, some of the people, they do extra for this dua. They say, Allahumma innaka afuun kareemun haleemun azeemun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu'an. So if you wanted to stick with the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Quli, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu'an. Oh Allah, you are the most forgiving and you love to forgive, so forgive me. So those people who are doing or having extra words, afuun kareemun haleemun azeemun, that is not part of the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Please, Imam Hisham, we wanted, inshallah, to make dua for everyone participating and for every Muslim and Muslimah. And please also, we need to make a dua for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take this calamity away of the COVID-19 or the coronavirus. And we need to make dua, inshallah, for everyone got affected by this virus, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them cure and heal, Ya Rabbil Alameen. We need to make dua for all the brothers and sisters who participated in the iftar distribution, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them barakah in their life. Allahumma ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Yes, Imam Hisham. I think we are 4 minutes away from the adhan.
اللهم لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك اللهم لك الحمد ملء السماوات والأرض وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شئت من شيء بعد يا رب العالمين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا المصطفى في الأولين وصل وسلم وبارك على نبينا المصطفى في الآخرين وصل وسلم وبارك يا ربنا على نبينا المصطفى في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين اللهم اهدنا بفضلك فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى وعلما نافعا وقلبا خاشعا ولسانا ذاكرا وعملا متقبلا. اللهم اجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا ونور صدورنا وجلاء همنا وغمنا. اللهم ذكرنا منه ما نسينا وعلمنا منه ما جهلنا وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وأطراف النهار. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم اختم لنا هذا الشهر العظيم بالرضوان والفوز بنعيم الجنان والعتق من النيران وأن نشرب من يد حبيبك المصطفى العدنان وأن ترزقنا النظر إلى وجهك يا رحمن. اللهم إنا وقفنا ببابك طائعين راجين مستغفرين فاغفر لنا. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا. أصلح يا رب أحوالنا أصلح يا رب أحوالنا. اشف أمراضنا وارحم أمواتنا وارفع عنا هذا البلاء يا كريم. وصلى الله على نبينا الهادي
الأسد. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
فيكم جزاكم الله خيرا. جزاكم الله خيرا إمام جلال. يا الله سبحانه وتعالى بلس يو. اللهم أمين. جزاكم الله خيرا إمام محمد إمام هشام. يا الله بلس يو يا رب العالمين. Thanks everyone shared the time with us. يا الله accept your siyam. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.